The PE, or price-to-earnings ratio, is the most widely used financial metric for analysts and stock pickers. But what is the PE ratio and how can it be used effectively as a stock picking tool? The PE ratio is calculated by dividing a company's share price by its annual earnings per share. It's a metric for measuring the relative value between two or more companies because it tells you how much you are paying as an investor for every dollar of profit that the company is earning. So what is a good PE ratio? 5 times earnings, 20 times, 50 times? Well, it depends. The PE itself doesn't tell the full story. As an investor, you are buying a piece of the company's future earnings and cash flow. Growth and risk both play a part in how much that earnings stream is worth. If two companies have exactly equal growth and risk, the one with the lower PE ratio is the better bargain. But every company is different, which is why PE ratios vary widely between companies and industries. Let's consider two stocks, Microsoft and IBM. Microsoft has a share price of $137.452 in earnings per share, giving it a PE ratio of about 30 times. IBM stock is trading at $143 with earnings of $13.61 and a PE of 11 times. This makes Microsoft almost 3 times as expensive as IBM based on price to earnings. So is IBM the better bargain? We need to dig deeper. Over the last 3 full years, Microsoft's operating income has grown at an average rate of 25% per year, while IBM's has declined at an average rate of 10%. These are two very different earnings streams and thus the difference in valuation. If earnings per share for both companies continue their respective growth rates into the future, Microsoft's earnings would surpass IBM's after about 4 years. The payback period would be 11 years for Microsoft shares, whereas with IBM, you wouldn't achieve payback even after 100 years. But this is a very simplistic assumption. The market makes assumptions about future growth, and sometimes those assumptions are rational, while other times they are excessively negative or irrationally optimistic. Microsoft's high PE multiple implies that investors have high growth expectations for the company going forward, whereas IBM's below average PE multiple implies low expectations. But circumstances can change. If Microsoft's growth rate declines, the market will likely revalue the stock. Likewise, if IBM's operations turn around and growth improves, the market might revalue the PE and the share price could increase. This is the kind of situation that value investors look for: low PE companies with the possibility of a turnaround and valuation expansion. The risk of value investing is that if the turnaround doesn't happen, then the share price decline will continue. Growth investors look for high growth companies like Microsoft and will often happily pay PE multiples of 50, 60, and even well over 100 times earnings. The risk here is that market expectations could be overly optimistic. High growth rates are often unsustainable, and if growth slows, the valuation will likely contract, leading to a sharp decline in a share price. So what is a good PE ratio? Well, we know now that there's no one-size-fits-all answer to this question. However, based on my research and current market conditions, I believe that most of the best opportunities are trading in a range today of between 15 to 35 times the earnings that the company can reasonably be expected to generate over the next year. If you like this video, then please post a comment below and let me know what topics you would like to see covered in a future video. Thank you for watching.